International. This is Paris Live on the half hour. James Mulholland with a summary of today's main stories. The leaders of France and Russia have held a frank exchange at their first meeting outside Paris at the Palace of Versailles. French President Emmanuel Macron said that he and his Russian counterpart Vladimir Putin had discussed disagreements, notably on the conflict in Syria and the fight against terrorism. Macron said any use of chemical weapons in Syria would be a red line that would draw an immediate response from France, while urging a closer partnership with Moscow in fighting the Islamic State armed group. Vladimir Putin said he wanted stronger economic ties with France after years of recent restrictions. The former Panamanian dictator Manuel Noriega has died in Panama City at the age of 83. Noriega was in hospital recovering from a brain tumor operation. In the 1970s, the former general was promoted to the head of Panama's secret police, a role which saw him become a key CIA informant and a U.S. ally against Fidel Castro's Cuba. He was accused of orchestrating the disappearances of Panamanian opposition figures. Noriega took power in 1983 and oversaw a brutal dictatorship until 1989, where he was ousted by the U.S. He was later jailed in Florida on drugs and laundering charges. He was also convicted in France and later in Panama for murder, corruption, and embezzlement. The military in the Philippines says it's retaken parts of the southern city of Marawi on the island of Mindanao from Islamist militants. Fighting continues in the area with thousands of civilians trapped. The authorities blame the militants for the deaths of at least 19 civilians. 17 members of the security forces have also been killed, along with more than 60 rebels. General Eduardo Arno, the chief military officer, told the Associated Press that armed groups had planned to burn the city to the ground to extend the influence of the Islamic State armed group. He said that militants wanted to kill Christians in the nearby Iligan city during Ramadan to mimic the violence in Syria and Iraq.